Viewers of Toyota Times, athletes now, good evening. I am Morita Kyonyosuke, anchor person. I'm Kosuka Takahiko and Ashida Hajimu. Vancouver 2010 figure skate qualified 8th Kozuka-san and the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games athletics 4x100m relay bronze medalist Ashita-san with Olympian and Paralympian we will deliver webcast. As you can see, Ashita-san and I are seated on the wheelchair for wheelchair basketball. That is because today's special feature is the heated Toyota Derby, fighters in wheelchair for the wheelchair rugby and wheelchair basketball and wheelchair tennis we will focus on today. So how do you find this wheelchair? I used the wheelchair racer for the para athletics. I've had the experience with the racer, but because of the difference in sport in terms of turning or going sideways, I think it is different. This wheelchair's shape and maneuverability is different from what I've experienced. Well, this is my first time. To right and left, I can make the turns easily. For athletics, you have to go straight. Yes, we have to fight for time and we have to go straight and the lightness is needed. So there is a difference in this way. We are to focus on the events using the wheelchairs to look at the fun and the challenges of the games. As we heard from the comment yesterday, regarding the information you got from the program, with smug face, let's spread the news. What is a smug face like? Smug face. Spread what you've learned. So, Toyota Times Live, and please add the hashtag. So make the posts of cheering with the hashtag Toyota Times Live. And so remember the smug face of Kosuka-san. We are cheering from 47 countries and regions, 234 GTTA, and for Tokyo 2010 Paralympic Games, 66 GTTAs will participate. Kosuka-san, please. Now, first medals from GTTA. We have Canada's Rivard, the 50-meter freestyle Rivard bronze S10, and Widiash from Indonesia, silver medal Widiash. Congratulations, we have these medals. For the Olympic Games, we had also the congratulations for the medals. This time also, and the president for the Paralympic Games and the Olympic Games, he said, go out to win, Mr. Toyota said. So let us continue to celebrate during the Paralympic Games. So we are delivering the program from 7 p.m. every day. We have the English version through simultaneous translation for the Toyota family in the world. Due to the time difference, for regions difficult to watch it live, if you missed the program, YouTube archive, refer to them, please. Now, Kozuka-san's favorite talk, Yaris. You can say Yaris Kozuka. Maybe I should change my name. Well, people are inputting a lot of comments even yesterday. I wasn't here yesterday, but you had the Yaris yesterday. Sorry that we showed the Yaris yardstick yesterday. When you are not here, Kosuka-san, and when you think what is Yaris all about, please refer to the archives. Toyota Times, Olympic Paralympic special site, please access them. And YouTube, Instagram, comments are very much welcome. So please watch until the very end. For yesterday and today, regarding the competition held, we'd like to share with you the performance of Toyota athletes. For the GTTA athletes and countries and regions, we show them in red, para table tennis. And it's now Sweden, C8, standing position. Impairment is middle degree. Against France, lost. So one win, one loss. For C6, Denmark's Rosenmeier, standing position. The serious impairment, straight win against Italy, two wins in a row. For C11, intellectual impairment, Belgium's Van Acker last night against Venezuela, straight win. And today, win against Japan, two wins in a row. Wheelchair rugby, Caldwell, Canada. Of course, they lost against UK today and yesterday, and today against the USA lost. France lost against Japan, and that's Australia and GTTA competition between France are happening. They have lost one game each, so this one is going to be very important. For swimming, women's 50-meter freestyle S10, the lesser severe for the physical impairment, River has won the bronze medal. This is the first one event for her, and four more events to happen, so look forward to it. As for the different class, S6, Turner Island qualified eighth for women's 50-meter freestyle. Today, the swimming happened in the following way: 200-meter individual medal way. SM stands for individual medley, and physical impairment, 6. Rang was not qualified, rang from Norway. SB stands for breaststroke. Physical impairment 8 plus. Ireland's Keane has passed the preliminary, first qualified. Look forward to the gold. And mixed 4 by 50 meter, 2 men, 2 women, different impairment athletes join. Greece, Tsapatakis, 11th, not qualified. As for powerlifting, as we said, for women's 41 kilogram, Widiash of Indonesia, 98 kilograms she lifted, silver medal, last time bronze from Rio, so two medals in a row, and a nicer color medal she gained this time. Congratulations. Wheelchair basketball, men's primary league, Serios USA, the medalist from Rio, won against German, and Canada lost against 78 Spain, but Gonshin had gained 15 points. He did a great job. Wheelchair fencing, women's epee individual, category B, is a severe class. Zhou Jinjin from China, she won the 5 games out of 6 in the preliminaries and lost in the semifinal against RPC. And she is now competing for the bronze medal.
Now today's special, that's the heated Toyota Derby fighters in wheelchairs. Among various events, there are events where GTTAs are fighting each other, that is, the wheelchair basketball, wheelchair tennis, and wheelchair rugby. And those are the three events that I'd like to share with you the excitement. First, about the basketball. We are now on the wheelchairs for the basketball. The size of the court, the ball, and the height of the goal, are they exactly the same as the Olympic Games? And as you see on the left, to reach higher, the one of the wheels would be lifted. And they will fight for 10-minute quarters. And there is a rule that is indicated on the top, depending on the level of the impairment, points are given to each athlete. And the sum of the points of all the players and the court have to be 14 or less. With severe impairment, the point is lower, and if it is higher, then that means it is the less severe impairment. So in this case, it is 1.5 time plus 4 plus 3 plus 1.5 plus 3. So in this case, it is within 14. What is your reaction to this rule? By including such a rule, I believe that would add another interesting part. Because, first of all, there will be more opportunities for players with severe impairment. And with that, the team also, of course, has to adopt different tactics. And that will make the game even more interesting. And therefore, I think this is quite an interesting role. So, there may be a team with more players with 3 points, or other team may be comprising the mixture of the low point as well as high point players. And we want to see the confrontation between the Nick Gunson of Canada and Steve Serial of the United States. First, about Nick Gunson of Canada. When he was in high school, he lost one of his legs due to osteosarcoma. This is the second Paralympic Games Rio Olympic Games. And back then, the Canada was ranked number 11. He has 4.5 points, meaning that his impairment is less severe.
My athletic superpower is probably speed, quickness, that sort of thing. I kind of play as a point guard, shooting guard, but my main thing would be speed. I try to out-push people any chance I get.
He mentioned about speed in his interview. Because he has 4.5 as a points, he is quite mobile and agile and can be part of the offense. And did you see the car behind him? That's RAV4, his car. And I realize that many athletes tend to prefer RAV4. I agree. And now, the Steve Serial of the United States, he has 3.5 points. When he was 11 months old, the surgery that he received resulted in the partial paralysis of his legs. He started wheelchair basketball when he was 14 years old, and this is the fourth Paralympic Games. In Rio, the United States received gold medal, and of course this time again, the gold medal favorite. You see, he is almost jumping or flying. He also mentioned about his style of play.
I think my athletic superpower is my shooting ability. You know, it's a really important skill in wheelchair basketball. It's the thing that separates Team USA from other countries, and it's one of the things that we're going to lean on in our quest for gold.
So he mentioned about the ability for shooting. I had a hands-on experience of the wheelchair basketball. Have you ever done that? Well, this is my first time to be on the wheelchair for basketball. So why don't you try to move your wheelchair? The push the wheels and you will move forward, and pull and you would move backward. If you the push with your left hand and the pull with your right hand, then you can make a turn. Yes. If you want to turn in a different direction, then the push and pull by different hands. By so doing, you have to rush to the spot where ball is the thrown, and then you have to bounce a ball once when you turn wheels twice. And that's extremely difficult, because at the same time, you also have to make a shoot. So while the driving your wheelchair, all of a sudden, you realize that you are right beneath the goal. And therefore, if you try to shoot the ball, and then the ball might hit you because you are right beneath the goal. So you have to do two things at the same time, playing a basketball and maneuver your wheelchair. Yes, it was difficult, challenging, yet interesting. Canada belongs to Group A and the United States Group B. The Canada lost in the first match and United States won. You have to be among the top four in the group comprising six teams, and there may be the match between DTTA athlete teams. Next, about wheelchair tennis. We have three men's singles players, DTTA. First, the Gustavo Fernandez of Argentina. He was donned with the Grand Slam title on multiple occasions and ranked number 4. And then the Martin de la Puente from Spain. This is the second Paralympic Games. He's ranked number 11. And Mr. Miki Takuya, he was best 8 in London and Rio, and he is currently ranked number 12. Let's take a look at the rules. This seems to be exactly the same as Olympic tennis. Except that you can return the ball within two bounces. And depending on the level of the impairment, the players might use electric wheelchair. That's what is called the quad class. And also, there may be a moment when the player turns his or her back into the opponent. And I interviewed Mr. Miki about the interesting part of the wheelchair tennis. Yes, first and foremost, the wheelchair and the player would act as a unit. And there is a speed, and we try to catch up with the ball that was hard to reach. So those two are the points for interest. He mentioned about how the players reach a ball, which was hard to be reached. Well, I talked to Mr. Yokota, who is a close friend of Mr. Miki. He is in charge of the sport enhancement and community promotion. And according to him, right at the moment that he hit the ball, he would predict the direction of a returned ball and make a move. And therefore, you can also follow the Mr. Miki instead of just tracking the ball. Let's take a look at the practice of Mr. Miki. At first, he is trying to place a service. He lifts up the ball with a high toss and he returns it. You see that he's moving right and left. And now to the right again. See that he is swinging his racket and at the same time, keep on moving. Pick up the ball. That seems to be extremely difficult. Mr. Ashida, what is your reaction to the chair work that you have just seen? Well, I have never played wheelchair tennis, and therefore this is based upon my speculation, imagination, and a sport. If you have to play with more factors that are different from you, meaning that you have to use a tool and other means, so here is a player, and then here is the racket and the wheelchair and the ball. There are so many factors that have to be moved instantaneously. Therefore, I would say that it is extremely challenging. Because of that, the player has to work as if it is a part of the wheelchair, or the wheelchair is part of his body. That is extremely important. At the same time, you have to move your wheelchair to exactly the spot where the ball is coming. And when I say exactly, that means that has to be the position where you can swing a racket the way that you want to swing. In other words, it has to be the spot where you can return the shot. That's right. Without the wheelchair, the players may be able to hit the ball even when they are a bit far. In the same, exactly in the position that you can hit it hard. Yes, it has to be the accurate positioning. And so the operation of the wheelchair seems to be the key. And also, when the ball hits the wheelchair, and then because the wheelchair is regarded as a part of the player, then the point would be given to the opponent. I saw that the way he was practicing was extremely difficult, but what about the play itself? So this is what Fernandez said. What's exciting about the wheelchair tennis? It is exciting because each player exposes their physical as well as emotional or mental limit.
To expose one's limit, well, his body, the neck, we focus upon his neck, thick neck. So very challenging sport to challenge the limit. From Spain, we have the video of Della Fuente, so please watch. Wheelchair tennis is new and different, so it's challenging. I never dreamed to turn the wheelchair so quickly. I maneuver the wheelchair with such speed, I have injuries all the time. Wheelchair tennis truly taught me the way to live beyond my limit. Smiling has always been a part of me. Smiles help me to get over the very difficult times, to overcome my limitations. Before filling the Dharma doll's eyes to make a wish, let's use this opportunity. If I can be in the best eight in Tokyo 2020, I will fill the second eye. Let's do it. See you in Tokyo. The president, when he appeared on the first day, for each athlete, there is only one story. That's the feeling I got from the video as well. As for De La Puente, amongst the wheelchair tennis top players, they are very good friends. With Fernandez, De La Puente on the left and on the right, Fernandez, they're very good friends. They are like a family, he says. And Miki of Japan, they play online games together with Miki's. Together they're playing online games, it seems. For Miki, you have this sort of an aspect of athlete Miki. Do you know what this is? Oh, this is quite beautiful. It's a photograph. Look at the right hand bottom. Copyright. Takuya Miki. You see? His hobby is photo taking. So, the photo taken by Miki. Other photos by him. Taken by, shot by him. It's beyond a hobby. I would love to make a postcard of this. When I received this information, I really wanted to share this with you. Oh, it can be created into a postcard. It's so beautiful, his photos. Ashita-san, with athlete Miki, you are very good friends. Did you know about it? I thought I was real great friends with him, but I didn't know that he had such a great hobby of photo taking. I didn't know. You didn't know. But still good friends. So you have know some aspects of him. With Miki-san, when we are both in Japan, not going to games abroad, so he's like a big brother. When we are at the same time in Japan, we share problems. And in after Rio, he had a major injury. And he was going through very difficult times through rehabilitation, and he has recovered. So for this Paralympic Games, I really want to focus on him and pray that he'll do a great job. Because of his difficulty, his passion on Tokyo is very big. So due to the injury, the trigger has been made to focus on the seat. That is, the Toyota's vehicle development division members started to create Miki's seat. And I asked at the pep rally in-house that there is a know-how for vehicle seat development. And when the division members sought comfort, the performance came down. Strong shot without fatigue. To make both happen, they adjusted the seat height and flexure, and after many kaizen, the chair work improved dramatically, and his service ace numbers went up greatly in the matches. So these two development team members are fighting together with athletes. GTTA, three GTTAs will participate in the wheelchair tennis starting tomorrow, so please cheer for them. Now, next, Toyota Derby has already happened in the wheelchair rugby. What is the sport all about? Wheelchair rugby illustration. Well, major difference with the Olympic Games rugby is that it's gender mixed and indoors using basketball court. And as you can see, it's not elliptical, it's a round ball you use. And you can pass the ball forward. As you can see in the illustration, in the parasport, it is the only one where on purpose wheelchair contact is allowed for its tackle. And the wheelchair differs depending on defensive versus offensive. The offensive type wheelchair is small and simple. You can go through narrow spaces. And the defensive, you have to stop the opponent. So there is a protruding part in front of the wheelchair for the defensive type. So the offensive type is sometimes stumble over due to the stopping by the defensive wheelchair. And just like the previous example, there is the point value allocation. and on the court, the four athletes' total point has to be within 8 points. Now, the high pointers with less severe impairment often use the attack, and the lower pointer, severe impairment athletes carry out the defense. So the defense athletes have a protruded front, and you can tell when you look at the games by the difference in the wheelchair types. It's really cool. I think the wheelchair was really cool. And yesterday I looked at the, watched the games, and I was so impressed. You are really flying from tackles. It's like the USA's car chase movie. You are rushing with your vehicle, and then the police car comes in. That's the sort of image it looks like. Yes, a small wheelchair on the offensive in narrow spaces, and then the opponent's defensive wheelchair comes in to stop. It's thrilling, really dynamic and spectacular. The tire, you have a puncture on the tire, and you can exchange the tires during the match like this. So you have this person to change the tire. Do you think you've seen this before, Kozuka-san? It's like a motorsports tire exchange. Very good. Like this, it's similar. At Gemba, you have the mechanic, and to repair at the spot, this is just like the motorsports Gemba. On day one, Mr. Toyoda talked about the affinity with motorsports. You have this here as well, the affinity. Morita-san, wait a minute. The color, the coloring. It must be Yaris. Did you notice? Here it is. Kozuka-san, here it is. For Yaris Kozuka, I am very satisfied. Well, we talked about the Yaris yesterday, you see. The first time yesterday, we had the Yaris Yachik. Well, today I see Yaris for the first time. It's my second time to see the Yaris. Don't compete against each other. Stop it. Yaris once. You saw Yaris twice. So what's going to happen? My name is Yaris Ashida. Wow. Now, Kozuka-san, in the Paralympic Games spots, he now has made the Yaris debut. I think he's happy now. So please introduce the three GTTAs. First, Jonathan Iverna from France. Due to hereditary disease, he used his wheelchair. Based on the rule, as we mentioned, he has an allocation of 3 points from 0.5 to 3.5. The number is higher, so the impairment is less severe. And he's the captain of France, world ranking 6. Next is Cody Caldwell of Canada. At age 20, from a diving accident, he was paralyzed in both arms and legs. Point for him is 2. And his Canada team, Rio 2010 Paralympic Games 4th, aims at the medal at Tokyo. Wow, look at his photo. So many clashes can be seen. And the candidate for the gold, Riley Batta from Australia, captain of Australia team. He has a point of 3.5 allocated. He was born without legs, and on the right hand fingers he has impairment. It's his 5th Paralympic Games, and he aims for 3 golds in a row this time. So really focus on that. And on that, in the Olympic Games part, I think you saw Matthew-san already from the president of Toyota Australia.
In the case of Riley Batta, he's captain of the rugby union team. And really, it's such an awesome game when it's played at this Paralympic level. It's very, violent's the wrong word, but it's aggressive and it's fast. And it's actually very exciting to watch. They're very well recognised in Australia and very well appreciated for their achievements and also their contribution to the community. And most of all, don't forget that there's actually an Aussie cheer that you may hear the Australians, which is Aussie, 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 oi, oi, oi. So please enter into the spirit and try that as well. Thank you.
From Matthew-san, president, the cheering, Aussie, 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 oi, 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 in this manner. running back Australian team. Please cheer for them. After Bambos, Argentina. Yes. So the preliminary round has started. Group A, you have Australia with Bat and France with Iverna. GTTA competition has actually started. Group B, Caldwell, Canada. If they are in top two and go to the finals, there will be further Toyota Derby. That Toyota Derby. Possibly the barrier will be Japan. For Japan at the Rio, after the bronze medal for the 2018 World Championship, they have won. And won against Iverna's France yesterday in the first match. So the barrier for Toyota this time could be Japan. Of course, we want to cheer for Japan, but we are going to cheer solely for GTTA. The president's comment has come in. Oji, oji, oji. We know now that Mr. Toyota is watching, so let's not forget Aussie, Aussie, Aussie. So we have looked at the sports using wheelchairs. We have looked at many. Ashita-san, what was your impression? No, I myself play in standing position as an athlete. The wheelchair athletes, method of training and their thinking, I do not fully, in a true sense, understand. But by using the wheelchair, it means the difficulty of the sport becomes more challenging. And the chair works fun. If that could be understood, I think that would be great. And the wheelchair athletes, they use the wheelchair as a means for moving. So by looking at their performance, it would be great if our hearts are moved by watching them. You put it very nicely, to be moved. We have actually ridden on the wheelchair, and through many athletes, wheelchair and athletes truly become one. And there is a seat development team. Together, they are fighting. We have covered many stories. So thinking about them, please cheer for them. This has been today's special feature, the heated Toyota Derby, fighters in wheelchairs.
Lastly, I'd like to introduce to you the GTTAs that will be competing tomorrow. First, para equestrian. She was introduced yesterday as well. She's in grade 4 out of 5 grades. The 5 being the least severe, therefore, the second least severe grade. This is the first the Paralympics, and she fell from the horse in 2017, and she suffered paralysis, semi-paralysis, and she is competing with her loved horse. And starting tomorrow, the para-athletics various events will take place. A T11, that's truck events, and 11, that is about the visual impairment, and a T11 being the most severe impairment. And there will be 5,000 meter game. And the Joaquin Castro, he is the athlete, and then he is wearing the spectacles, and he is holding a rope together with a guide called the Vocero. And if they win the medal, and then both of them will be donned with the medal, and therefore they are close friends. And when we sent the message for support them, they returned us back with the message. Hello, we are very much delighted to be part of the Toyota family, and thank you for your love, and we will soon come to Tokyo. Thank you very much, Toyota family. To the friends from Toyota family, my name is Darwin, and thank you for your support and love, and see you in Tokyo. If they win the medals, then this is going to be the first medal for Ecuador. So we will be there to support them. Then, para table tennis men's singles, Rosenmeier of Denmark, Van Acker of Belgium, and Anderson of Sweden. Two matches and quarter. I'm in the qualification round already finished, and depending on the results of other players in the morning tomorrow, and then they may have a chance to be qualified for the final. Then wheelchair rugby, the France with the Evener, they will be competing against Denmark. That is quite strong because they won over Australia. And then the Australia with bat, they are competing against Japan. And then the Coldwell of Canada, they are meeting with New Zealand, which is quite strong. And then para-judo, the rank number 7 in London and number 5 in Rio de Janeiro is the Hangai Shizuka. She is visually impaired and 48 kilogram class. And the judo takes place tomorrow. And then the wheelchair basketball, the Gunsens Canada is going to make a first win against Turkey. And USA with Serial, they're going to fight in the second game. And then the Canada wallet and the wheelchair basketball, they made a first win. And then they're going to match against Japan. And the Miki Takuya and Martin de la Puente will be playing in the first round in the wheelchair tennis. And para rowing, we have Skorstein of Norway. She is going to be in the TR1, PR1, and that is about the lower limb of the single skull. This is considered to be more severe type of impairment. She's a two-player athlete, and this is the second time following Rio. But during the time, she made three straight victories in the World Championship. She is now aiming at gold this time. And then Bush would be in the PR2. This is going to be the pair skull from France. The gold in London and bronze in Rio. Now what is aimed at is gold. And next para swimming. The Gunnarsson of Ireland, S11, that is considered to be the most severe impairment, visual impairment, 50-meter freestyle. And then SM7, that is about the medley relay. And this is considered to be less severe. And we have Mr. Gawilan in Philippines. He lacks the tip of his left arm and the two legs beneath the knees. And the results that is going to be introduced in the Toyota Times Athletes now, and also you can check it up in the site as well. And also you can find out SNS information about athletes. For instance, the Mr. Mickey's Instagram shows his impression about the Paralympian village when he first came into the village. And you can also send a message of support by SNS whenever you have any new findings. If you want to make the look of smug, please add hashtag Toyota Times Live. You want to do it again? Is that your smug look? Thank you. Thank you. So let's continue to support more extensively those athletes. Well, this being the third the Toyota Times Athletes Now, Kozuka-san, if you can introduce the comments. Yes, there are many. Kaoru T and the Instagram. It's amazing. Toyota is involved in the development of tools. In fact, that is one Toyota. That symbolizes one Toyota. Now in YouTube, yes. And the comment on the YouTube, Yoshisuke-san says, middle name of Kozuka-san, is that Yaris? Yes, my name is Kozuka Yaris Takahiro. It's now formal, starting today. Tadapi-san says, to throw ball to the height of the goal, that's extremely difficult, I would imagine. Yes, in fact, the height of the goal is the same as the Olympic basketball. You can't use your knee. You can only use your upper body and the arms. Ririka-san, basketball, tennis, and rugby, now that we know more about the rules, that would make the watching games more interesting. That's the beauty of the athletes now. And the Mr. Toyota, Toyota just sent us the message that the move that means leaves you with the more impression, be moved. You were aware of that, right? Yes, I'm going to use that in that way as well. Well, this is the first time that you worked with Kozuka-san. How was it? It was really interesting. I tried to make fun of him whenever I could. Yeah, let's be friendly in three of us. Next, tomorrow, the Attention Toyota 7 in Triathlon. That is, you swim, you ride on a cycle, and then run. And this is going to be extremely demanding, and there will be seven GTTAs, and they belong to different classes. So unlike in the case of the wheelchair competition, there won't be any confrontation among Toyota athletes, and therefore, they're all of them are quite leading, and therefore, let's support all of them. It's amazing, the GTTAs in all different classes. And also, to make athletes from overseas, to help them feel at home, let's send the videos and photos to support them with the song for support by Naoto Intilaimi. Well, today's program was featured by Morita Kyonosuke, Oi of Toyota Times Athletes Now, Kozuka Takahiko, and Ashida Hajimu. So see you again tomorrow.
Loneliness in my heart. Oh yeah, we all give.